I have another question which has been raised. Do you have links with Al-Qaeda?
If we had a relationship with Al-Qaeda and we believed in that relationship, we wouldn't be ashamed to admit it. Therefore, I would like to tell you directly and also through you to anyone who is interested to know that we have no relationship with Al-Qaeda.
In relation to the inspectors, there appear to be difficulties with the inspectors, and I wondered whether there was anything you could tell me about those difficulties and whether you believe they will be cleared up when Dr. Blix and Mr. Bareda come back to Baghdad.
You are aware that every major event must encounter some difficulty on the subject of the inspectors and the resolutions that deal with Iraq. You must have been following it, and you must have a view and a vision as to whether these resolutions have any basis in international law. Nevertheless, the Security Council produced them. These resolutions, implemented or not, or the motivation behind these resolutions could lead the current situation to the path of peace or war.
يروح إلى السلام وممكن أن تجعله يروح إلى الحرب وعلى هذا الأساس
Therefore, هي it is a critical situation.
بالإضافة إلى الظلم الواقع
على الشعب العراقي. Let us also remember the unjust suffering of the Iraqi people. For the last 13 years since the blockade was imposed, you must be aware of the amount of harm that it has caused the Iraqi people, particularly the children and the elderly, as a result of the shortage of food and medicine and other aspects of their life. Therefore, we are facing a critical situation. On that basis, it is not surprising that there might be complaints relating to the small details of the inspection, which may be essential issues as far as we are concerned, and the way we see the whole thing. It is possible that those Iraqis who are involved with the inspection might complain about the conduct of the inspectors, and they complain indeed. It is also possible that some inspectors, either for reasons of practical and detailed procedure or for some other motives, may complain about the Iraqi conduct.
قد يشتكون من تصرف العراقيين ولكن كل منصف
Every fair-minded person knows that as far as resolution 1441 is concerned, the Iraqis have been fulfilling their obligations under the resolution
وينفذون ما عليهم بدقة ايضا.
When Iraq objects to the conduct of those implementing the Security Council resolutions, that doesn't mean that Iraq wishes to push things to confrontation. Iraq has no interest in war. No Iraqi official or ordinary citizen has expressed a wish to go to war. The question should be directed at the other side. Are they looking for a pretext so they could justify war against Iraq? If the purpose was to make sure that Iraq is free of nuclear, chemical, and biological weapons, then they can do that. These weapons do not come in small pills that you can hide in your pocket. These are weapons of mass destruction, and it is easy to work out if Iraq has them or not.
We
have said many times before, and we say it again today, that Iraq is free of such weapons. So when Iraq objects to the conduct of the inspection teams or others, that doesn't mean that Iraq is interested in putting obstacles before them, which could hinder the efforts to get to the truth. It is in our interest to facilitate their mission to find the truth. The question is, does the other side want to get to the same conclusion, or are they looking for a pretext for aggression? If those concerned with their aggression, then it's within their reach. The superpowers can create a pretext any day to claim that Iraq is not implementing Resolution 1441. They have claimed before that Iraq did not implement the previous resolutions. However, after many years, it became clear that Iraq had complied with these resolutions. Otherwise, why are they focusing now on the latest resolutions and not the previous ones?
May I broaden the question out, Mr. President, to the relations between Iraq and the United Nations and the prospects for peace more broadly? And I wonder whether, with all its weaknesses and all the difficulties, whether you see a way in which the United Nations can realize that objective for the benefit of humanity.
The point you raised can be found in the United Nations Charter. As you know, Iraq is one of the founders and first signatories of the Charter. If we look at the representatives of the two superpowers, America and Britain, and look at their conduct and their language, we would notice that they are more motivated by war than their responsibility for peace. And when they talk about peace, all they do is accuse others they wish to destroy in the name of peace. They claim they are looking after the interests of their people. You know as well as I do that this is not the truth. Yes, the world would respect this principle if it was genuinely applied. It is not about power, but it is about right and wrong, about when we base our human relations on good, and respect this principle. So it becomes simple to adhere to this principle, because anyone who violates it will be exposed to public opinion.